that's where my heart is turned.
Well, hi everybody, welcome back to MC Shaving for the next shave in the Shave America series. We're doing Florida today. So I have a few things that I want to talk about Florida. To start off with, we're going to talk about the most famous piece of Florida that everybody knows about, Walt Disney World. In 1971, Florida became the home to Walt Disney World. Sadly, Walt Disney passed away in 1966 and never had the chance to see his vision for the park come to life. That was a pic of the construction of the castle back in 1971. So that was the very beginning of what would become the huge tourist vacation spot known today. Now, if you've never visited the famous park, take witness to some of the lesser known details, such as the placement of trash cans are about every 30 feet. Now, this system was implemented based on research by Walt Disney himself. He studied people to see how many steps someone would take before throwing their trash on the ground. So it's pretty weird, but it's real. Every 30 feet, you're going to see a trash can. Now, if you're taking a stroll down the paths through Liberty Square, you might notice a yellowish brown section running through the red path, you know, on the ground. Well, that represents the sewage that would have run through the streets during the Revolutionary period. You wouldn't find any indoor plumbing during the historical time, so there are also no bathrooms in Liberty Square. So staying true to the times. There are numerous tunnels that run underground throughout the Magic Kingdom, which contain break rooms, electrical operations, rehearsal rooms, storage, and much more. Smellitzers, yes, that's a word, were used to entice you with tantalizing aromas. Now, I don't think that they do that much anymore, but at one point they pumped out smells to tie into the theming of shops, rides, and even floats during the special events. You know, you get the scent of freshly baked cookies or bread or smells from a restaurant, and you know, things to make you happy, you know, the pheromones, etc. So it was quite ingenious. Now, the less prominent are the fact that lightning rods are scattered throughout each park at Disney World. So Florida is the lightning capital of the world, and there's lightning everywhere. So to protect its folks, there's lightning rods all over the place. There's even one on Mickey's ear, which is really weird. But let's see, under Walt Disney's idea, he wanted to have a real futuristic city called Progress City. So that would have been part of Disney World. However, EPCOT, which stands for Experimental Prototype Community of Tomorrow, is where it's based, and it holds his unique concepts, and it's still today a ride that you can do within EPCOT Center. So that is the opening for our Florida shave, talking about Disney World. Now, the scents for Florida, pretty simple, right? Orange and bergamot. Well, we're going to go with orange today, and this is the Orange Chill. There you are, from Sterling. So we're going to do a little cold shave today, and I put some frost drops in from Sterling to even heighten it up a little bit more. Oh, and I forgot to mention the opening song. Now, it's called Old Folks at Home, but many would refer to it as Swanee River. That is the state song for Florida. Now, I did take a little bit of time and whip this up beforehand because we have the tidbits that I'm going to give you. We had a long intro, so we are using the Evo brush from Omega. This is the synthetic brush I got from the East Coast Wet Shavers Secret Santa. So it's a Facebook group. Thank you to whoever you are. I still don't know who you are, but I love this brush. Whipped up the Sterling. I mean, this is really got some nice peaks, and smells orangey, and I could smell the menthol in there. So we're going to have a good shave with that today. We are going to use the 3D West Coast Shaving printed razor. This is a three-piece. Inside, we're going with the Rockwell. You can see the two dots. So this is the third shave on that. To top it off, we're going to use some Thayer's Cranberry Orange. This is a small mister bottle that I got from Christmas. So we're going to do that. And then we're going to top it off with some Orange Chill Aftershave Splash from Sterling. So, let's wet the face and apply some soap. It turns out that there was an invite from the East Coast Wet Shavers to do a Florida shave, and it just so happens that this was up on deck. I haven't done a state shave in a while, and I had Florida ready to go, so that's why I'm doing Florida for you guys today. So thank you, Curtis, for the invite. You guys are probably going to see this late. This may not even go up until Sunday, but I had a very busy day. My daughter needed new glasses. You would think that she would tell somebody. She kept saying that she didn't like the glasses that she had because it was one solid glass. You know, like the bridge, the nose piece, the eyes, and it was all one solid thing. It didn't have the nose pads where it would rest real easy. So she said it bothered her nose, and she has, you know, some acne. So she didn't like those glasses. She kept asking me for new glasses. And that was the excuse. Well, come to find out, she had needed a prescription change. And those aren't only a year old. Just barely a year old, I should say. So, I don't know. Get the spray bottle out. She's always on those little electronics. Still breaking this brush in, but it is nice. Very soft. So we had to take care of that. I guess that's part of parenting, right? Reading into what the kids are asking you. You know, half of it was right. It did bother her. But, you know, she didn't want to tell me that her eyes were blurry. And that she needed, you know, to go back see the doctor. Nobody wants to go see the doctor. But we took care of that. Picked them up today, so now she's wearing them. She's only 11, gonna be 12 real soon. And, you know, it had to be fashionable and... not make her look bad in any way. Ooh, man. Menthol's getting to me. Woo! They ought to use this stuff in the movies. Oh. I'm happy to see you. I feel like I've been away for so long. Some of you guys had subscribed. Welcome to all the new subscribers. Thank you to the ones who had subscribed and stuck it out with me. Being patient. Thanks for all the comments too. You know, I did receive a few comments on the Global Shave Club shave using the new fat guy. I received some comments on the Naked Armor shave. You know, there's a loyal brand folks out there, and there's nothing wrong with that. You know, and you can speak your mind. Thank you for keeping it all clean. It's all welcome. You know, as long as you're not swearing, you know, bullying, shaming anybody, you know, that's fine. You have the right to speak your piece. folks haven't been around as long as you. Oh, look at that, I'm shaving up. Well, you know what? I must just keep going that way. This is the first pass, but I lost track of what I was doing. It's all right, it's really not completely against the grain. I know you're not supposed to go against the grain in your first pass. That's where you're gonna get ingrown hairs. I'll just shave the other way. Pretty effective though, let me tell you. Not bad. I'll just shave the other way when we go for pass two. I'll just add a little bit of cold water and wow, that menthol jumps at you. Ooh, feels nice. Reignite the smell of the orange. Yeah, smells good. Okay, let's share some more stuff about Florida. In 1998, Florida passed a law requiring daycare centers to play at least 1 hour of classical music every day. The bill went from the 1990s hype surrounding the Mozart effect. The belief was that listening to Mozart would boost children's intelligence. While one 1993 study seemed to support this hypothesis, more recent findings show that merely listening to Mozart's music produces no such cognitive enhancements. So, I don't mind it. I don't think it's going to make me smarter, but I don't mind it. The Florida Department of Transportation has a fleet of service patrollers known as Road Rangers. Now get this. They will bring you gas if you run out. It is a limited, no-cost highway assistance program to motorists to improve highway safety for emergency responders and the motoring public. If you're on the roadway and need assistance, call *347 on your mobile phone if you're in Florida, and they will bring you gas or help you. That's pretty cool. And we have lots and lots and lots of nice whipped up leather. And I love the smell of this orange. Sterling makes a good soap. I'm all about Sterling, absolutely. In fact, it's probably not needed, but there's definitely enhanced menthol with the menthol drops, which are also Sterling. Nice and cool. You know what? This kind of goes today because even though I'm in Western New York area, you know, Buffalo, snow, cold weather, it got down into the upper 20s last night. We're warming up, believe it. It was, I think it got into the upper 40s, maybe even lower 50s today. So for this time of year, heat wave, woohoo, put your shorts on. Get your t-shirt out, put your bathing suit on, we're going for a dip. A little polar bear action. I have been secretly acquiring, well not secretly, but I haven't been showcasing anything on my other channel. For Legos. I've been still collecting, but as of late, I've been dipping into some of the older, retired ones. A friend of mine went through a rough patch all within a couple months. I think it started right before Thanksgiving of last year. He lost his dad. And I didn't know this, but his mother had cancer. And in January, he lost his granddad. And that same week, his mom took a turn for the worse, went into hospice, and he lost his mom. And he was, he's a strong guy, you know, down to earth fella. And we met delivering pizzas, believe it or not, back when I got out of high school. And we've always been friends, we've connected, we've hung out and done things, but not on a regular basis. And I don't know how it happened, I don't know if I inspired him or what, but he recently got bit by the Lego collecting bug. We've been in contact probably more than we have in the last decade, and he's been buying up all of these Lego sets and getting into the hobby, and he's been acquiring a lot of the older stuff, and he wants to build a little city like I had, and that kind of refueled my fire to go get some of those older sets. I'll show you a picture sometime. I'm starting to put the city back together, so I'll showcase it on the other channel, and I may just give you a glimpse in this one, but that's for another day. Let's still talk about Florida and wrap this shave up. So John F. Kennedy Space Center, originally known as NASA Launch Operations Center, is located on Merritt Island, Florida, right next to Cape Canaveral. Now, it was commissioned in December 1968. Kennedy Space Center has been NASA's primary launch center of human spaceflight, including launch operations for the Apollo, Skylab, and Space Shuttle programs. The site contains many locations, such as a vehicle assembly building, shuttle landing facility, launch control center, visitor complex, headquarters building, and many launch pads. There are many pictures, but I'm going to show you this one, which is actually a shot of the Apollo 10 rocket that's rolling out from the vehicle assembly building to the launch pad. So take a look at this. That's pretty cool. Now, they don't do the shuttle missions, or they're not really private in their space research now, but they still do launches from there. In fact, that's where SpaceX launches from, and a lot of the space programs that are working on the different Mars stuff and the moon stuff and the space station, they still launch from there because Cape Canaveral is supposed to be an ideal location to take off. I guess it's I don't want to say near the equator, and I don't have notes around it. I tried to find something. I remember hearing about it a while ago, but I know that it's a nice location to launch from, even though there's a lot of storms and lightning and stuff, which is not good for that environment. But I think the positives outweighed that negative. If I find it, I'll post it in the comments underneath the description of this video, but take my word for it. All right, and just to finish up with some quick tips and facts about Florida. Coming at you, fast and furious, okay? The state has the most toll roads, the most bridges, and the most golf courses than any other state in the U.S. There's no place in Florida you can go that is more than 60 miles away from a body of salt water. The drink Gatorade was invented in Florida and got its name after the mascot of the University of Florida. And the Florida Everglades is actually a slow-moving river and not a swamp or wetland, which it's often described as. Additionally, the Everglades are the only place in the world where crocodiles and alligators live together. So that, my friends, is all about Florida. It feels so nice. Yeah, it didn't do too bad. Maybe a little touch up here and there. There we go. Just a little touch up in the usual spots. Now this razor is a nice smooth razor. This head is not aggressive. The Rockwell blade is a nice blade. Thanks to Dan, who watches my videos, for sending those to me. He gave me a bunch of them. They're going to good use, my friend. Still got the feedback. Yeah, that's success right there. Okay. Yeah. Let's pull the plug. Get a quick rinse in. All right. You let me know how this shave went. I tried to shrink the time down a little bit so I didn't spend so much time yappity 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 yappity. I know no one wants to hear me anyway. Okay. Let's get some toner on there. Cranberry and orange. Now this is a mister. I've used it a couple times. And I'm going to mist heavy. Ooh. Yeah. Mmm. Really brings that orange scent out. Pairs well with that soap. Very nice. Ah. Okay. Shake this up a little bit. We're going to go for the Orange Chill After Splash. Mmm, smells like freshly peeled oranges. It's got a stopper in there. Shake some out. Mmm. Ooh. I get a hint of menthol. I wonder if there's a menthol in the aftershave. Wow. Very cooling on the face. There's definitely menthol in that aftershave. Ooh, that is nice. It's like I have a bushel of oranges in front of me. That is our Florida shave. Thank you very much for joining me. Appreciate everybody for subscribing. And I love your comments. Please leave some more comments and give us a thumbs up, like the videos. I hope everybody is staying safe. We just got approved for another vaccine here in the US. What, Johnson & Johnson? The FDA just approved an emergency release of that. So we have three companies now. Pfizer, Moderna, and Johnson & Johnson. So there's gonna be lots of vaccines out there. I hope everybody gets theirs and you guys stay safe. We're turning the corner. We're turning the corner. Be patient, we're gonna get there. And then hopefully, maybe we'll have a big shave gathering. East, west, north, south, central, whatever. Let's all get together. Let's have some fun in the community. Thanks to everyone for watching. Be well. We'll talk to you in the next video. Bye-bye. Plantation and for the old folks at home.